All right, hi guys. I am going to make a 12 by 12 panel. This is a piece of MDF that I have gessoed. It's a clear gesso, so it doesn't look like there's anything there, but there is. I have some artist loft white that I've just mixed almost one part paint, one part Floetrol, and one part water. So it's a little bit drippy. So we're going to see how to, but not really, it's just kind of the perfect amount. So it just should kind of just drip right off of that. I've made two cups because of these big panels. I find that I usually don't have enough paint in my single flip cup to make it spread out as much as I like. So there may be a little bit of silicone in this one before, because this is from the other, from my last clock one, which I don't think I will publish before I publish this video. So there's a preview and sneak preview of the blue. So this is a metallic Anita's purple. This is the blue, dark blue from Craft Smart. This is King's Gold from the Apple Barrel. Let me just stir that in. I can see where there's Floetrol still. And then this is the bright magenta from Apple Barrel. And this is the Tuscan Teal from Apple Barrel. And then I also have these Liquitex inks. My last one failed. And based on what that clock looks like, I think I'm going to break up with the Artist Loft Silver again. Because it just, even though I put a little bit in, it was just made it kind of silver mud. I don't know. I don't really like it. But I want to try some of this ink in the magenta, so this is the Liquitex magenta ink, and I'm just going to put it into this already Floetrol and watered Apple Barrel magenta, just to see if that gives it a little more of a pop. I don't know, I just figured I would try it because I have the ink and it's kind of the same color. Oops, that's just to see if it'll give it kind of a brighter pop, or just to see what will happen, essentially. Should have had a before and an after. I don't know what it'll do to it. We'll see. Maybe nothing. But I have it, and until I make another Floetrol and ink video, which may be today. I don't know. I'm in the video mood. And then I'll use it. And then I have this iridescent bright gold that I thought I would add to that King's Gold to give it kind of a pop of color. There's some purple metallic, but I thought I would just add some of this metallic to see if I can tell with that ink in the acrylic paint. So let's try it. Why not? Hopefully I'm loud enough. Ooh, that looks really pretty. Maybe I won't mix it very much and see what it does. So I'm going to put a little bit of the CRC silicone. I took this up with me and I used washi tape on it to travel with it. And then I never took that washi tape off. So I'm going to put a little bit of silicone in the purple. Oops. And in this magenta. And the blue, the clock that I did that I'll probably post after I post this video was kind of dimply, so I don't want the dimply. Ooh, sheesh. But maybe I'll get the dimply anyway because of that goof. So I'm just going to pour this a smidge. Maybe not so much so that that silicone doesn't all the way mix in, so that the cells are a little bit bigger. There's already some silicone in this purple. Had to take a quick pause. So I'm going to mix these colors into the white. Let me take this out. So when I gessoed it, you can tell this is just a piece of MDF. This side you can tell is smooth. That side you can kind of hear that calcium carbonate on there. So if anybody is ever interested in how to make their own gesso, leave me a comment and I'll make a video. Because I learned from another YouTuber and it's pretty awesome because I don't like spending a lot of money and it works great. So I'm going to got my gloves on, pour this, give it kind of a mixing pour. Oh, did I put silicone in these? Yes, I did. See what happens when I take a break? There's some blue. Did I? Yes, right? Oh, I guess we'll find out. If not, maybe it'll mix those with the Floetrol. That's ridiculous that I can't remember from 20 minutes ago. That's what happens though. Yes, I did, because I held it up and I took the sticker off, right? That was this video? I don't remember. That's ridiculous. Oh, that's big and gloppy. We'll see how this turns out. I like that I'm putting a lot in there because maybe it'll spread out more when I see that's like almost all the way full. This is going to be overlapping onto my this is going to be pouring off my can off my drop cloth. Okay, already that's really, really pretty. Yeah, that was this video. Wow, my brain is fried, dude. Okay, so here's my cup. So if I don't have to add stuff later, then I like it better, but I'm happy to add stuff later. Okay, that is a lot of paint in there. Okay, I'm gonna try and flip cup it. Flip cup it, is that a verb? It is now. Oi. That thing is full, totally full, and obviously it's all spread out. Now this is looks like it's going to be kind of super springy colors. It's already starting to sell up. Let it stay there for a second. That is a lot. That's my biggest, my most full flip cup that I've done. Fullest flip cup. Yeah. Tap some good juju in there for a good pour. Yeah, when I post this other clock video, I'm breaking up with the silver again. Because that last video, when it made everything totally muddy, and I'll show you this while that's sitting. Look how pretty ugly. This is one that I did not show the video on, and they've got a little bit of selling around, but for the most part, it's just ugly. This is the ink one. Yeah. So, not super happy. I did take those other pours that I did from that last video, and I have this little cheapy one from Walmart, and I did pour from my cups onto here, and that turned out pretty cute. It didn't really sell up, but I don't know. I'll send that one to my daughter. She'll like it. She won't know what it was supposed to be. Okay, so I'm gonna... Oh, that's a lot. That's a lot. That's awesome. Look at all those cells. Okay, I'm just gonna get some blue up here. Where there's a lot of pink. I know it's hard to see. That's a lot of... cells. Yay! My faith is renewed in my capability as an acrylic pourer. I try not to be too discouraged the other night. Okay, I'm just going to do a super slow tilt. I don't even think I'm going to torch this. Although when I say that, I still go back and torch anyway. But we'll see. Oh. Just going to try and drag this out to give that paint a place to go. See, pour that way. Oh, this makes me happy. Oh, I don't want to lose. Okay, I'm going to pour this way. I love this blue. See, I don't know that I'm even going to be able to tell. Although that pink looks really bright. Okay, I'm going to keep pouring this way. Will I ever be able to tell the difference if there was ink in there? Maybe not. But, okay, I don't want to slow tip. Come on, little babies. Okay, see if that helps it a little bit more. Do slow. I really like that turquoise. These are getting all stretched out. Okay. I'm going to get a little bit crazy and I'm going to pour on those edges again. This is why I made this other. Because I may pour over here too and get all those stretched out edges since I can. Watch, this is going to be super white like the last time I did this on my first video. We'll try it. That's a lot of blue. I like this really deep turquoise. I know I said that twice. Sorry. Not as much pink left over. Alright. Oh, there's a cup in the stick in there. Genius. Well, let's just give it a stir while we're there. Okay, see, there's not much left in there from my first one. See how these are getting all stretched out? I'd rather have them not stretch out. But then that's also a lot of paint to have on the board, too. But I don't want to stretch out my... See, that's too much white. But I like these cells, though. And I don't necessarily like that white, but I feel like I gotta balance it out. Ugh. I'm just gonna do like dollops. Where it's spread out. I like this. I'm gonna dollop on top of that there. Ooh, that's a lot of white. Even more white where I just said I didn't want so much white. I'm going to pour that way though and see what happens. It's so funny because every time I do the second pour, there's like less white in that cup, but more white shows up. Okay, let's get that big old gob off the side. Off that top left corner. That's not too bad. I can dribble on top of that. And let's get this little framey part out over here. Slow and steady. Winning the race. Alright, I think I'm going to call that done. Here it is a couple hours later. Still wet. But looking good. Thank you guys so much for watching. I appreciate all your comments. If you want to like and subscribe, that would be awesome. Thanks.